In the previous video, we added UsersignUp, the functionality to create users. In this video, I want to make sure that users can sign themselves in and get a JSON web token, the token which we then need to attach to request to reach our future protected routes. We don't have protected routes yet, we will add them later, but for now, let's make sure that we can get a JSON web token at least. So it's time to create some tokens. Let's create a new route, a post request to /auth/sign-in. The idea here is to get email and password, then to go to database to see if we have such a user, and if we have one, then we create a token. So create sign-in controller in authentication namespace. Inject storage in the constructor. And as always, method invoke, which accepts a server request. Now at first, we instantiate an input and validate it. Then we need to fetch a user from a database. We don't have such method in the storage, so go ahead and create it. Let's name it findByEmail. Inside we make a select query. We select ID, email and password from table users with a provided email. And here, once we fetch the result, we need to check it. If the result is empty, we can throw an exception. User not found. Create this new class and we can extend it from runtime exception. Then, if the result is not empty, we need to map it into a user object. Let's also create a class for user. It has ID, email, and a password. Create these fields. Make them public. Okay, now move back to the storage and let's map a database row into a user. We have a single row and then use it to create a new user object. Don't forget to cast ID to integer. Then we return it from the storage. Done. Now move back to the controller and let's handle the request. We call this storage findByEmail. On success, we receive an instance of user. And then let's focus now on error cases. What do we have here? We have a user not found error. In this case, let's return 401 error, saying that authentication failed. We don't have such a response yet. So let's create one. Open JSON response class and add a new static constructor unauthorized. Inside it, we return a response with 401 status code. And in the controller, we return this response. In case of unexpected error, we return internal server error. Then the happy path. Now we need to check that the password sent with the request matches the password stored in the database. So we can use password verify function. It requires a raw password and a hashed version. Let's update our input class and add a method to get a raw password. Public function password. And return a password key from the request body. By the way, we can use this method here, when we create a hash of the password. Move back to the controller and verify the past password within the request with a hashed version of it stored in the user object. If this comparison fails, I again return an unauthorized response. If we have a valid password, I return a 200 response. I know that the token is still missing. We'll come back to it soon. Update dependencies, and with that we have this setup. Now let's save it and try this out. Open requests file and add a new request. A post request to localhost port 8000/auth/signin. And the request body will be the same. Send this request and we get back a 200 response. Now if I change the password and add one extra T, we fail and receive 401 response. And the same happens if I send an email which doesn't exist. So this is working as it should. Now we are not done yet. We want to return a token, don't we? Now for that I'll add another library, Firebase PHP JWT. This library will help us to encode and decode JSON web tokens. So how do we use that? You see here we have an example. And to create a token we use JWT and a static method encode, where we pass a payload, some data that we pass into the token, and we pass a secret key. That is the key which only is known to the server. So to create a token here we use JWT class and call a static method encode. Now here first of all the payload. What do we want to pass to the client? Maybe we want to pass the user's email and an ID. So I create a new array, we have an email here and an ID. Then with key exp we can provide a time, how long the token is valid. It shouldn't be too long for security reasons, because the token is stored on the client and if someone steals the token, he will get the full access to our API. So it is better to make the token short-living. Here we can provide a timestamp, when this token should expire. Let's make it 1 hour. Then we need to provide a key and I'll again use an environment variable for this. So open .env file and add a JWT underscore key and let's name it secret. And pass it here when we create a controller. Now open the controller, update its constructor to accept a key. Then we can use it as a second argument here, where we encode a new token. Okay, and with that, let's go back to sign in request and send it again. Now I get back a token. Now if I copy this token and then go to jwt.io, there we can scroll down and decode our token. Remember that the token is not encrypted, it is just encoded in a base 64 string. And this is what is inside our token. We have an email address and a user ID. The token will expire in 1 hour. So this is how we now add a token and return it to the user. Let's extract this logic into a separate class. I don't want to keep all these details inside the controller. Create a new class Authenticator. Inject a storage and a key. And create a method authenticate with email and password. These are the arguments we receive from the user input. Copy and paste the logic from the controller. So we search for the user, then we check the password. If it is not correct, we can throw a custom bad credentials exception. Create it right here. Otherwise, the password is correct, and we create a token. Return it and fix variables. Here we get an email, and here we get a password. Let's extract a constant here. Token expires in. So the method returns a promise that resolves with a token. Let's use this class in the controller. Replace storage and a secret key with authenticator. Then we call it and provide the values from input, email and password. The promise now resolves with a string. We use it to build a response. Add a new error handler for bad credentials exception, and in this case, return unauthorized response. That's it. Update the dependencies, create an instance of the authenticator and inject it into the controller. Again, check that everything works. Here is the token. And if I change the password, it works as expected. Done. In the next video, we will actually use the token and send it within the request to a protected resource. We'll learn how we protect such resources and how we can verify the token.